come on in, have a seat. Seat. Sorry if my voice sounds a little bit weird. It's because of those bad boys. Yeah, they look cool, but there's a sacrifice to be made, that's for sure. So, you must be my 7 o'clock. No idea. No clue. It's totally fine. Not to worry one bit. I am thoroughly prepared for this exact dilemma. Yes, it is a common one. Yeah, believe it or not, a lot of people come in here just like you. No idea. So, every single year, I draw we have right here. Halloween 2018. Halloween makeup looks. So I certainly hope there will be one in here that you'll like the look of. But no worries if not. We can also come up with something totally new for you. And also, please do keep in mind that none of the looks that I've drawn up in here are set in stone at all. These are just ideas, that's all. If there's anything I can possibly adjust to make you happier, I'd be more than willing to do that. Mm-hmm. You can change the color scheme, the shapes, the placements, the style, anything you want. The first one I'd like to show you is the skeleton. This, I'd say, has probably been my most popular look from the binder this year. So, if you're looking for something fresh and unique, this might not be the right one. But it is very cool. So, please don't let its popularity dissuade. I also want to let you know that each and every look that I have in here, I also have in stock the costume, hair, nails, makeup, of course, everything to go along with it for you to rent. So, no worries about that. The next look is the mermaid. I think this one would look gorgeous on you. Just my opinion. Take it or leave it. But I really think that this would perfectly suit your face shape, the color of your eyes, and I think you would look great with a blue wig. Yeah. Especially a greeny blue teal. Yeah. And of course, the this one is definitely very glitter focused. We've got pink glitter, some purple glitter, teal, blue, gold. Mm-hmm. Next, these next two looks actually. First, we have the werewolf, which I know this does look quite masculine, but I think it has enough of a feminine touch with the smoky eyes, beautiful defined lips, that it balances it all out. Or if that's a little too ferocious for you and you want to go for something more demure, we have Little Red. So I have some colored contacts you could wear for this if you'd like. This is perfect if you want something that lets you look pretty but with some the most gorgeous red wool coat here. Big hood, very long train, beautiful. And I think that these bright red lips would look very nice for you. I would definitely be sure to select very cherry, shiny spirit, but I also think that this could pass as someone who's been turned to stone by Medusa, especially if we add in some cracks. You can make it look like aging stone or marble. So completely grayscale. We could put some gray contacts on you. Pull some white through the brows. Do a beautiful white wig. Or Medusa. This is another one with great glitter effects, lots of touches of gold sparkles. You can do a peachy pink lip, or if you would like more drama, we could do black. I think that would look great here. And here's our last two. I don't know if you're a Studio Ghibli fan at all, but this is a Princess Mononoke inspired look. Obviously, it's not completely canon. I've taken some artistic liberties and expanded upon her simple face paint design with further little details, framing the eyes, the chin, Yeah, I have this necklace right over here if you'd like to have a look at it. It's made to look like teeth, of course. Nice and lightweight. Super comfortable to wear. Oh yeah, that looks cool on you. I'm not just saying that, I promise. It looks sick. Okay. And last one. Again, perfect if you don't really like scary or creepy and you just want to go out and look cute. The deer. So we would do a bronzy glow. Outer edges of the face. Nice and blushy. Little bit of smoke around the eyes, nothing too heavy. And of course, plenty of white speckles. So what do you think? Okay. Something pretty, but with a twist of gore. Mm-hmm. Got it. How would you feel about doing that mermaid? But we could do something a little gory and have the edge of your mouth being caught by a fish hook. Yeah, a mermaid that got reeled in. So, what do I have that we could use for the hook? You know what?
We could actually use
a safety pin. And scar wax, or we could also do it with silicone, third degree, parts A and B, mix them together, makes an awesome sculptable mixture that you can then paint over. It looks just like skin. It's super fun. Do you mind if I ask where exactly you plan on wearing this makeup tonight? A party. Cool. Is it the party right across the street? Sounds like they're having a great time. We might have to crash that. Okay. Your party is at 10. Oh, great. We've got plenty of time. That's cool. And how long do you think you're gonna stay? You'll have to see how it goes. True. If you're gonna be, like, moving around a lot and dancing, I think it's probably best that we go for the silicone. Mm-hmm. So anyways, do you like the sound of that at all, or would you rather do something else? Yeah. You're down. Cool. I'm so glad. I really think this is gonna look awesome on you. And it's gonna be totally unique. I haven't had anybody ask for anything like that so far, so I think you're gonna stand out. Before we get into special effects business, first things first, we've got to do the beauty makeup, okay? So, do you have any makeup on your face at the moment? A little bit, okay. Like a BB cream, sure. Any mascara? Alright. On your lips? Okay. In that case, I'm supposed to be Marcy. I wanted to do the bluish gray skin, but it looks weird if you don't commit and do your hands too. And I cannot be covering my hands in paint and getting it all over my clients and all the Yeah. So, like we talked about, I'm gonna use a slightly green tinted primer. Sort of minty looking, isn't it? Yeah. So, this is going to combat any redness, discoloration, irritability on your skin, alright? So I'm just going to squeeze. Do you think there's going to be a lot of pictures taken tonight? Probably. was fine. Needs a little bit of a chance to dry before we set it, alright? Yeah, if you are too hasty and you set your makeup before it's dry, it can get crackly looking, textury in a bad way, especially if you tend to have drier skin. With a lovely fan brush. I love the snapping, crackling, popping of the cauldron. Makes me feel like we are in a witch's lair in her potion brewing room. Quite sweet, sweet, sweet. Is set. Now we're gonna start getting into the colors. So, would you like your color scheme to be the same as in the drawing I showed you? Or would you like it to be adjusted to something a little different? You like the deal? How would you feel about adding in some more purpley tones? Very crucial question to ask you as I start blending away at your crease. Could you cast your eyes down? Perfect, thank you. But that wasn't the question. No, I wanted to ask you, what is your favorite Halloween candy? I guess it could be any sort of candy, because any sort of candy can be Halloween candy, right? It's all backing you up on that one, of course.
Bigfoot should have been a look in this year's Halloween makeup catalog. Halloween makeup 2019, all cryptids. I think I'm onto something, don't you think? Great. Will you come back to me next year? Let me do your makeup again if the whole catalog is all cryptids. I knew you would. I knew we were on the same page. It's time to tie in the purple. How do you feel about this lighter purple called Celestial, or more of a deep plum called Drama? Quite fittingly, I would say. So glad you said that. I totally agree. I think it's going to be an awesome pop of color. I think I'm going to do it on the inner half of the lower lash line. When you're adding a color for the sole purpose of bringing a pop to the eyes, that low inner lower lash line, or just the inner corner, I think are the best two places to do it. But we've got to switch to a smaller brush. That big old rounded blending brush is not going to be doing us any favors when it comes to maximum pigmentation. If you could adjust your gaze slightly upward for me. Have a look at this lovely glittery pumpkin up here. Ooh, can we have a closer look at this for a second? We're not in any rush, right? Oh yeah. you said 10? Cool. Isn't she beautiful? Isn't she how it radiates from this warm yellow at the bottom to a vibrant orange to a deep orange. I'm dreaming up an eyeshadow look inspired by this bad boy as we speak. Awesome curly stem. But of course, the crackly gold glitter is the very best part. Really brought something to the table. Yet another marvelous decoration to admire. Halloween mobile. Crow in a cage. Little stars and moons. witch's hat, pumpkin, a kitty, green-eyed kitty with a little star collar. Dapper owl in a wizard's hat, or a witch's hat, who knows? The key. Do you think there are witches who, instead of vape tricks, do cauldron tricks? Eyeshadow's looking great, but it's missing glitter. I've got this beautiful roll-on teal glitter. Excuse me, shimmer. Nice and fine. If you could look down for me. Awesome. Just going for a bit of a halo eye effect here, so mainly blotting this. Ooh, yes, love that. Then in your lower waterline, I'm going to use this shimmery aqua green eyeliner. So if you could look up, good. Perfect. Mascara, but only on the lower lashes. Black mascara for the top, going classic. I just think that it will be important to pull together the eye look, give some deep dark contrast to all that shimmer. Nice. Lashes. How dramatic do you want to go? If you're going to be at this party for a long time, we don't want to go too heavy, or else the weight of it might cause the edges to start peeling up prematurely. That can get kind of uncomfortable. We might want to go for something more lightweight. So I've got the Ardell You'd like to go all out on the drama factor, but to be slightly safer, go for something more lightweight. I have the Faux Mink Wispies. Similar effect, but slightly more delicate. I want to go for the Wispies. I think that's smart. Very, very thin strip of adhesive over the band of the working on the rest of your makeup. Pretty much the polar opposite to the skin tone that I've developed on myself. Using the 3E method, 3E, that shape, forehead, cheek, and jaw. Good, 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 good. Oh, that looks beautiful. We try a swatch of it on your wrist to see if you like how it mingles with your skin tone, your undertones and everything, texture of it. Yeah, okay. If you could just give me your hand. Good. I'm just going to use my middle finger. Not to flip you off, but instead to sweep. What do you think? I love it. Yeah. You've got some warm undertones that are really going perfectly. The peachy, peachy, peachiness. Okay, so let's go with that one. If you want, you can give me a slight smile. Beauty pageant smile. Even give me a little wave if you're feeling fancy. A gloss. Obviously, a peachy gloss is what is going to best complement those now perfectly peachy cheeks of yours. So I'm going to recommend either Buxom full-on lip cream in the shade Creamsicle, or the NYX Intense Butter Gloss in the shade Sorbet. This one is a bit darker and orangier. This one is softer and pinker. This one is more high shine. This one is, of course, also shiny, being a gloss, but far closer to the matte side of the spectrum. You like on the face chart the sort of Cirque du Soleil details, the lines sweeping up from the brow and down under the eye. All right, in that case, I'm going to go in with this shimmery blue liner called the Glam Azure and give you those lovely sweeps. now it's perfect. The beauty side of things looks to be complete. Now we can move on to special effects. So, do you have any preference of if you happen to have been hooked on the right or the left side of your mouth? Do you tend to pose at a certain angle or side in pictures? Got it. In that case, right here will be just the spot. All clean. And don't worry, it is pretty comfortable. Feels a bit strange at first because, you know, nobody's used to having silicone wounds adhered to their face. But it's one of those things that before long you don't even notice it. You'll forget that it's there. Reach up, touch your face, and be like, oh my goodness, what is that? Good. And actually, of all the fancy tools out there, still my favorite one to use to apply and sculpt third degree is just the back of any old brush. A rounded edge, though, to get a smooth, seamless transition onto the rest of the skin. Good. Oh, that looks cool. You're gonna love it.
Yeah.
So, I have a wig in mind for you that I hope you will like. Long, straight, and blue gradient. I'll fetch it. Here she is, and smooth and starts with a deep navy blue, nearly black at the roots, fades to a rich deep blue, into a vibrant teal, perfectly matching the teal of your makeup. Do you like it? I'm so glad. I think it's gonna look great on you. Okay, and it is a lace front. Nice, natural hairline. Gotta start with a wig cap to secure and hide your natural hair. Kinda looks like pantyhose. But no. Right. Gonna start your forehead. Reach this all the way. Now, for the wig itself, bring that around over the back. I first like to pull that lace down too far to the forehead, and then bring it back so it kind of pulls back extra hair that's left peeking out from the cap. Okay. And then just need to gently brush out your gorgeous new head of hair. Nice and now your third degree is nearly set, but not quite at 100%. We're gonna make use of this brilliantly textured red round sponge and just blot also to mattify. Slightest touch of beige powder. Good. Now I believe all that is left to do is your costume. So if you see hanging on the wall, just there, the third from the left, you can grab that right off the rack. There's a dressing room. And then once you're all dressed, we can do any last final touch-ups, alright? Okay. My teeth better not be covered in lipstick again, I swear. Oh boy. hiding in plain sight, as per usual. There you are, my pretty. Strange So it was the first time you saw your makeup in the mirror. What do you think? Okay. Great. Are there any touch-ups or adjustments? Anything at all I could possibly change to make you happier? Alright, just let me know if you change your mind. Oh, you saw those on display on your way back. These have been flying off the shelf. Some people can get a little bit twitchy, fidgety. It's not their fault. Can be kind of hard to work on. But you sat beautifully like a statue. Makes my life a lot easier. Which one's your favorite? I think I'm gonna have to go with the devil quirky. Yeah, I'm feeling that one. Alright, so you can throw those in your bag before you head off to your wild night of partying. Let me just give you one. Give your wig a brushing and smoothing. No flyaways, not a single hair out of place. You know what? Some hairspray will probably give us that effect better than a lifetime of brushing. Ultra fine mist. That way the hair won't get stringy or clumpy or sticky. Stay nice and smooth. You can give us a little bit of shine. So close your eyes. I'm also going to block them for you. Okay. And then, wow, that's wet. Just give it a nice smooth. Okay. Touch more blending on the face. finishing touch, lip gloss. And I'm actually going to give you this one because it is going to be crucial to touch up your lips throughout the night. And this shade looks so perfect on you. It just has to be this one. So I'm just gonna give it to you, okay? You just have to promise me you'll try your best to keep it touched up because it looks too good. Perfect. So, you've got your doggy stickers, you've got your new buxom sorbet gloss, and you've got gorgeous hair, makeup, and costume. Are you happy? Great. Thank you so much for coming to see me. If you need your makeup done for the holidays or birthday, you're just a night out. See you next time, okay?